एवरीबडी, सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू वर्किंग ऑफ जेके फ्लिप फ्लॉप विद द हेल्प ऑफ स्मार्ट लॉजिक सिमुलेटर ऐप. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ओपन द ऐप, देन क्लिक ऑन योर सर्किट, क्लिक ऑन क्रिएट न्यू, क्लिक ऑन प्रोजेक्ट, देन क्लिक ऑन दिस पेंसिल आइकॉन, क्लिक ऑन प्लस साइन एंड देन सिलेक्ट जेके फ्लिप फ्लॉप. सो सी वन जेके फ्लिप फ्लॉप हैज बीन एडेड. सो जेके फ्लिप फ्लॉप हैज डिफरेंट इनपुट्स लाइक प्रीसेट, क्लियर. अगेन वी नो दैट प्रीसेट एंड क्लियर, दिस इनपुट्स आर एक्टिव लो इनपुट. So if we don't want to use them, then they should be connected to logic 1. So here let's add logic 1. So here you can see high constant. So let's add this high constant 2 times. So we have added here 2 high constant. So this is first one and this is second one. So here what we'll do now, we'll connect this preset, we'll connect preset to logic 1 and we'll connect clear again to this logic 1. So preset and clear connections are over. Now let's move to clock. So JK flip-flop required one clock source. So here let's add one clock source. So here we can use pulse button as a clock source. So by using this pulse button, we can provide clock pulse, single clock pulse. So whenever we press this pulse button, then one clock pulse, only one clock pulse will be provided to this JK flip-flop. So here now let's make the connection. So output of this pulse button should be connected to clock input of JK flip-flop. Then JK flip-flop has J and K input. So here what we will do, we will add two toggle button for that two inputs. So one toggle button is for J input and other toggle button is for K input. So let's place this two toggle button at appropriate position. Now let's make connection. So output of first toggle button should be connected to J input. Output of second toggle button, it should be connected to K input. So input connections of JK flip-flop are over. Now let's move to the output side of JK flip-flop. So in order to check state of JK flip-flop, here we will require one light bulb. So let's add light bulb here. So one light bulb is added. Now what we will do, we will connect output of JK flip-flop to this light bulb. So now connections of JK flip-flop are over. Now let's try to verify operation of JK flip-flop here. Let's try to verify truth table of JK flip-flop. So in case of JK flip-flop, we know that when both inputs are at logic 0, then there is no change in the output. So see, J and K both are at logic 0. They are connected to this two toggle button and these two toggle buttons are off. Means they are at logic 0. So here if we give clock pulse, whether output of JK flip-flop is going to change? No. So now let's try to give the clock pulse. So see, for giving clock pulse, just I have to click on this pulse button. So when I click on pulse button, so see here you can see that one clock pulse will be provided as input to JK flip-flop. Okay, JK flip-flop will be triggered and its output will change. So in this case, whether it is changing? No, it will remain same. Why? Because J and K, they are at logic 0. Now let's change state of J and K. So suppose J is 1. Okay, now I will make J 1 and we will keep suppose K 0. So what is input to JK flip-flop? Now J is 1 and K is 0. After this, if we give clock pulse, what should happen? What should happen? So we know that in case of JK flip-flop, when J is 1 and K is at logic 0, after that if we provide clock pulse, then JK flip-flop will be triggered and its output will set. Okay, so whether output of JK flip-flop is set now? No. Why? Because we have not provided clock pulse. Though we have changed input J and K, output of JK flip-flop is not going to change. So here we have to provide clock pulse. So in order to provide clock pulse, I told you that just you should click on pulse button. So here we click on pulse button. So that's why one clock pulse will be provided to JK flip-flop and its output is going to change as per input J and K. So J is 1, K is 0. So that's why it is set condition in JK flip-flop. So here you can see that output of JK flip-flop is at now logic 1. Okay, now let's change state of this J and K. Suppose now J is 0 and K is 1. So in case of JK flip-flop, if J is 0 and K is 1, then it is a reset condition. Okay, so here if we go clock pulse, so see what will happen, output of JK flip-flop will become 0. So here after this, if we give any number of clock pulse, whether output is going to change? No, it will remain 0. Why? Because K is 1, K is 1 and J is 0. So that's now let's make J 1 and K 1. In case of JK flip-flop, we know that when J and K both inputs are 1 at that time, this is toggle mode. Okay, so output of JK flip-flop is going to toggle. So let's verify it. So here though we have changed J and K, whether output is toggling? No, because here we have not provided clock pulse. Now see, here I will provide one clock pulse. So when I give one clock pulse, so output which was previously 0, now it has been converted into 1. After this, if I provide again one clock pulse, then again output will toggle. So that 1 will be converted into 0. If I provide again one more clock pulse, again one more clock pulse, 0. So in this case, if we go on supplying clock pulse, then output is going to change continuously. If previously if it is 0, then it will be converted into 1. If previously if it is 1, then it will be converted into 0. So this operation of JK flip-flop is called as toggle operation.